getting things done, no? Na approach. May tinatawag naman na bullet journaling, may tinatawag na time blocking, asynchronous approach, meron ding mga sprint or agile approach. Actually, this is just a sample, ano? But you can do every hour. Bawa every 9:05, 10:05, 11:05, yun yung cadence mo of, ano, of answering messages. Diba? Pero at the end of the day, you know na begin, ano pa lang, for Monday, this is your highlight of the day. You're doing these things, mga minor things, mga messages, etc. Pero by the end of the day, you will be fulfilled because natapos mo yung main or major project.
So, good afternoon, guys.
Good afternoon.
Dami. So, yung agenda natin ngayon, pag-usapan natin yung parang general project management at saka time management 101. Marami kasing approach sa time management, eh. Iba-ibang concepts, iba-ibang principles, may tinatawag na GTD, getting things done, no? Na approach. May tinatawag naman na bullet journaling, may tinatawag na time blocking, asynchronous approach, meron ding mga sprint or agile approach, meron waterfall approach. Ang ituturo natin ngayon is Dennis approach. Okay. I always start with the high level. Ano ba yung gusto nating marating sa buhay, 'di ba? Hindi yung we're working on something na hindi naman natin alam kung ano yung outcome nun. Now, minsan we're doing tactical things na wala naman siyang effect or benefit in reality, 'di ba? So, we want to be efficient in terms of yung efforts natin is talagang nagmamatter, 'di ba? So I start lagi with the high level. So basically parang per project, ano, magbibigay muna ako ng principle and then we'll jump on the parang real life scenarios or actual scenarios, no. So normally meron kang project. So meron kang kunyari project ABC, meron kang DEF. So yung project, alam natin meron yung outcome, meron yung goal na marating, di ba? No, isang project is a this company gusto kong maka-achieve ng 100 million in 2 years. So meron kang measurable time-bound na ano, na goal. Now, para marating mo yung ano na yon, meron yan mga detailed activities, di ba? Oh, step 1, step 2, step 3. Okay? So, based on that, meron ka namang timeline. Kunyari, month 1, meron kang month 2, tapos meron kang month 3. Okay? So, month 1, month 2, month 3. So, basically, binibreak mo siya para malaman mo ano yung mga, kailan mo ano yung step by step na gagawin, kailan mo ma-achieve yung ultimate goal. Diba? So, for example, step 1 ito is month 1. So, kung isang buwan siyang gagawin, so meaning, yung susunod na step, dito na yun sa month 2. Okay? Pero yung susunod na step will only take 2 weeks. So, meaning, kaya kong gawin ito dito na may possibility mag-overlap hanggang month 3. So, depende. Or may pwede rin naman na hanggang dito lang. Okay? Diba? So, ang idea nito is that the project can be so big or so huge, pwede namang so liit lang. Diba? Pag maliit lang, so meaning, in a month, kaya ko pa rin magdagdag ng project. So meaning, multi-projects ka. In a way, which commonly, lahat naman tayo, parang multi-function, multi-project. Diba? So, in this case, kaya kong idagdag sa DEF. For example, si DEF, maliit lang to, kaya kong pagkasyahin itong dalawang first two dito sa month 1. Diba? And ito naman is dito sa month 2. Okay? Yun. So, now, ito is a zoom out version. Now, for example, itong month 1 na, itong mga to na nandito sa month 1, so for example, this month is March, this is April, this is May, no? So this one, ngayon, itong month 1, which is March, pwede mo ngayon mabreak yan ng apat na
weeks,
di ba? Week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4. Okay? Pangalan natin ito, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, meaning, yung ABC1, kailan mo gagawin yan? So, dito, ABC1 is, lahat yan nandito sa month 1, di ba? So, ang tanong ngayon, dito mo ngayon papasok yan. Okay, yun namang DEF number 4 is dito mo ipapasok sa week 3 and week 4. Diba? Ito namang DEF 5, maliit lang yan, dito lang yan. Kasi konti lang gagawin ko dito, ito lang gagawin ko. Bakit nagka 6?
DEF 4, 5, 6.
Ito? Eh, yung 6 nasa month 2 eh.
Ah, okay.
Diba? So, do you follow? So, ibig sabihin, ito tatlo lang yung, ano? So, next naman ngayon, ibibreak mo naman tong week. Kunyari, ano bang week ngayon? So, week 2. Okay, itong week 2, ibibreak mo ngayon 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
Right. Gusto ko
mag-work ng weekend, yeah? 7. Yeah. Diba? So, ito, gagawin ko ito ng Wednesday and Thursday. Ito naman, gagawin ko ng Friday. Diba? Pwede naman yung isang task dyan, the entire week mo siyang gagawin, tatapusin. So, that's the basic premise nung Dennis style.
Okay.
Oh, Dennis approach. Okay. Tatalo na tayo ngayon sa
actual.
HR admin. Marketing. March. Okay, April. Project workshop page. Ito yung kasi as sa playground we're gonna do workshops, di ba? So for us to do workshops, webinar or otherwise, kailangan natin gumawa ng ano mga activities ito. Yung e-commerce or e-commerce plugin so that we can accept enrollment online. Di ba? Next dan yung web page. So these are the activities. Yung kanina pinakita ko, project 1, 2, 3, these are the activities. Okay? So, ang question ngayon, magagawa ba natin siya within March lang? Pwedeng hindi. Kasi nasa second week na tayo eh. So, meaning, feeling ko, based on my gut feel, kaya kong gawin to ng March, itong dalawa natin. Then, yung content development, dito na yan sa April. Okay? As marketing, may plano tayo magawa ng promo yung ating early week promo sa the playground. Ad launch. So again, kaya ba natin, tingin nyo, with the current load that we have, kaya natin, considering meron tayo nitong dalawa, kaya natin ising ito? Isa lang, feeling ko, as a manager, kaya natin gawin to. Kaya natin pagsabihin itong tatlo na to. Ito. For the month of March.
Yeah, for March.
Okay. So, kaya natin ng March to. Okay. Yung ad launch, kunyari ako yung gagawa, okay, alam kong kaya kong gawin to ng March. Okay. Alright, so na-settle na tayo. Okay, ang target natin ngayong March is this one. So, tanggalin ko na muna sa picture to para hindi nakakalito. Basta alam natin, hindi, tanggalin ko na lang. Ito ko na lang. Alam na natin na ito yung target natin as a group. No, for the month of March. March week 2 na tayo ngayon, ano? Week 2. Week 3. Week 4, no? Tama. Okay. So, like for example, yung canvassing natin kasi nandito tayo sa week 2. Okay. So, kaya ba natin today? I doubt. This week kasi Friday na bukas, 'di ba? So you think Mars kaya to ng week 3, which is next week, yung canvassing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so ilagay natin yan dyan. Yung online banking, actually, wala naman sa atin yung control niyan. Mm-hmm. Ang ano lang dyan is, kailan natin in next week follow up. Diba? So, I think most likely, baka next week i-follow up natin. So, ilagay natin ito sa week 3. Itong early week promo, kaya ba natin next week?
Early week, yes. Actually,
okay, good. Tapos ako naman, so, kaya ko rin ito. Alright, so, itong e-commerce plugin, akin ito. Yeah, I think makukommit ko yan dito. So, week 3. Okay. Tapos yung web page, sabihin na natin, kasama na yung mga iteration, mag-fall yan dito, tsaka dito. Ano? So, week 4. So, meaning, yan yung commitment natin for the entire month. Okay.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Alright, so, tapos na tayo, no? So, kunyari, nandito na tayo sa week 3. Ito yung plan natin. So, ito yung commitment natin. We say commitment, we all expect, ito yung tinatawag na sprint, ito yung sprint natin for week 3. Kung weekly sprints tayo. Pwede rin kasing every 2 weeks, pero complicated na yun. Isa-isa-emulate na lang natin, nandito na tayo sa week 3. Okay, start of the week, ito yung commitment mo, Mars. So, lalagyan natin ng assignment dito. Then we have Dennis. Okay. So, ito yung mga commitment natin. So, ang ano dyan, by hook, ang mindset dyan, by hook or by crook, kailangan matapos lahat yan.
Mm-hmm.
Kapag hindi, kailangan meron tayo justification bakit hindi natin na-meet yun. One justification is hindi sumasagot, kakatawag. O kaya sinabi nung bank na talagang hindi kaya this week. So, that's a justification. Pero yung ano, nakalimutan ko, it's not a justification, di ba? So, ibig sabihin, you're not on top of what you do. Ang kaganon. Ano? So, sa sprint kasi, may tinatawag na daily stand-up. I think ginagawa natin before yan to have a check-in kung kamusta na to, kamusta na yan. Ano? Pero at times, mahirap din siyang implement dahil to be honest, in my case, this is I have more things that I do. This is just for the playground. Ano? I have other businesses that I run. So, hindi rin feasible for me to do stand-ups. So, pwede natin gawin is a daily end-of-day report. Either beginning of the day report or ending end of the day report. So, ako, I would prefer end of the day report. Like, I think in your case, di ba, kayo ni Ron, nagsasubmit kayo ng end of day report. Isabay na natin yung status dun of the things here, no? Na end of day, beginning of the day, of park, kumusta yung parking reservation, nagka-canvas pa rin, wala pang progress.
So,
parang ganun lang. Very quick, no? Online banking, I intend to follow this up on Thursday. Ang alam natin na pareho tayo ng mindset na sa Thursday ka magpa-follow up. Tapos pagdating ng Thursday, kinabukasan, tsaka may bigay yung hindi sumasagot. Ganon.
Okay.
Si AG naman, ganon. At the end of the day, sabihin ni AG, tapos na yung first fold, nandun ako sa second fold, etc. No? So, what happened today? What are your roadblocks? And then, what's your plan tomorrow? So, pag may pumasok na bagong ano, bagong task, minsan kasi kung sa akin manggagaling, di ba? Tatanungin kita, AG, kaya mo bang isingit ito dito sa current sprint?
Mm-hmm.
Pag sinabi mong kaya, di good. Wala na tayo pag-uusapan. Pag sinabi mong hindi kaya sir, dahil masyado, hindi ko na makukubit ito. Di ba? So, kung ngayon magsasabi sa'yo kung idadrop mo yung ginagawa mo,
or
unahin mo to, or ililipit natin sa following month.
Okay.
Di ba? You have all the right to say no. Okay. Pero, I also have the right to ask why. Di ba? Then, pwede natin pagtulungan. Ah, ganito, sige, baka pwedeng ganito, o ganyan gawin natin para mas bumilis yung trabaho. Or, baka kailangan natin i-overtime kung talagang kailangan. Di ba? Later on, pag gayang sobrang duguna ng ginagawa. And also, applies to you. Pag nagbigay ka ng task kay Mars, same thing, same approach. Kaya isingit yan? Oh, yes. Yes, no. Ganun. Okay, so this is the part 2 of our project management and task management. No? As discussed last week, pinag-usapan natin is yung macro level of planning and project management. So meaning, we have big projects, and then we set the activities, and then we set which months are we gonna try to accomplish each activity of each project. No? So this time, we are zooming in naman on the level of a weekly plan. So meron tayong monthly plan, and then we have a weekly plan. So what I did here, meron tayong, we are now in the third week of March. So Monday to Friday. So we just focus in here. Diba? So we focus here, at kahit alam natin na marami pa tayong, we have some tasks pa after this, kasi sinet na natin eh. Diba? So these are the dependencies of the subsequent tasks. Diba? So what I did here is, normally we plan it out on a weekly basis, especially if you have a team, we call it sprints. So now we are on a weekly sprint. It can be a group planning, it can be an individual planning. So ikaw sa sarili mo, you know what you have to do and when you need to do it, or when you commit to accomplish it. Diba? So in this example, para lang meron tayong privacy, nilagay ko person A and then person B. Okay? So sa person A, we agreed na she's gonna do a page, a web page. This is a coaching page. So meaning, we are consolidating different coaches. We're gonna put it in the page, and then people can book a call for each kung sino yung preferred nilang coach. So from there, natapos yung web page, this is the landing page, then we have to do a content. So it's a social media content where you invite people about this particular service that we provide, which is a coaching page. And after that, we have to also link it to Calendly. So it's another task to create a Calendly account for each of the coaches. And then, not related to this, pero meron tayong isang service, yung business registration for small business owners or online sellers. And we need to do an ad creative for that, especially na now that online sellers are mandated to register the business owner before April 15. So that's for the person A. Person B naman, meron ditong we target. We have one client who we need to register the SSS Philip and Pag-ibig. Diba? So that's one of the tasks of the person B. So may mga activities behind it or on top of this, pero generally the target is we have to register the client's SSS Philip and Pag-ibig. And then part of it is another service which we do. We are writing the book of accounts of a particular client. So yun yung disbursements, sales, and whatnot. And then we have an admin task of to canvas a parking reservation signage. Diba? So as you can see here, my projects, this naman normally is a small projects or day-to-day na activity. Okay? So ang let's start with this. So for example, if ako si person A, what I'm gonna do is estimate. So this one I think I can do in a day, probably 3 hours. This one I can do, say, another 3 hours or half day. This one I can do 2 hours. And this one I can do 2 hours. So lagay natin. No? So kunyari, malaki-laki to, 8 hours. This one naman, I think 4 hours. This one 2 hours. This one another 2 hours. Diba? But generally, I target to finish this by the week. Okay? So what I would do is, I think I will prioritize. Again, I'm teaching you, if I'm gonna do this, this is my approach. No? So I think I'm gonna commit. Of course, I'm gonna parang consider also, I may have some meetings as well. On top of this, may mga meetings. I have to do like another block or time hours to check my emails, etc. So mamaya pupunta tayo doon. Yun na yung day-to-day natin. Ito kasi, weekly plan pa lang. So more or less, I know, for example, si person A, alam ko may mga, this is the AM, this is the afternoon, PM. Alam ko, I have meetings here, na naka-preset na yan. Okay? So, ito na lang yung mga slot na pwede kong paggamitan. So, also, this one, it makes sense na I can finish this by entire Tuesday. I'm gonna do this. Itong coaching content and content bakante yung AM ko, I will do this here. Itong coaching Calendly, I would say half day lang ito, so ilalagay gagawin ko to dito. 'Di ba? In business registration 2 hours lang, and then I will do it here. So as you can see, may mga bakante pa ako in reality, 'di ba? So doon na ako, that's where I'll try to do some other tasks that I have or whatever, or you know, you can talk to your team na I can take on other additional tasks kasi based on this I still have some slots or available time. Okay, there are instances naman, especially for person B, na this one is difficult to estimate because we don't know, because there are two third party entities involved. Kasi we don't know what the availability of these agencies, you don't know their response, gaano katagal, di ba? So what I would do is I will target to basa, I'll do my best to target it on Friday, but on a daily basis, every 10 a.m. 10 a.m. I will do a check-in with the people involved. The messenger, the manager, the boss, SSS field, check-in. How are we doing here? Do I need to do something today for this task? Nasa akin ba yung bola? So, pasa ko lahat yun. Diba? So, the following day, 10 a.m., i-double check ko ulit on kumusta na yung status of this PhilHealth, kumusta yung status ng pag-ibig, whatever. Diba? Kung may kailangan akong decision or there are things na nasa akin yung bola, then I'll have to do that at this particular time slot. Diba? Until such time na, basta ang importante, I am not dropping the ball on a daily basis. Diba? So if you have to put it in your calendar, kasi sa calendar, you can put it in calendar, basta 10 a.m. I will block my time to do SSS field ng pag-ibig until matapos ko to. Same with the books writing. Okay? So I think I can do this in 10 hours. For example lang, either I can focus it all in Monday or I'm gonna split it 2 hours a day. So from 1 to 3 p.m., gagawin ko tong books writing hanggang matapos ko nung Friday. Diba? Ito naman canvas parking reservation, same thing. I can do this ay, again, there are dependencies here. Especially, you are doing canvassing. You have interfacing with the suppliers. Diba? And not every time naman is available yung supplier. Diba? So, gagawin ko, every, say, 3 p.m. naman, every 3 p.m. is I will put a calendar 15 minutes, 30 minutes just to check the follow-up tsaka the supplier. Diba? Until such time na matapos siya on Friday. Kapag hindi, dun papasok yung roadblocks. Diba? On a daily basis, part of this every end of day, say every 5 p.m. or 4 p.m., you will compose an end of day report saying na this is the progress of each one of these. These are the roadblocks. This is my plan by tomorrow. So my plan tomorrow is I'm gonna do 10 a.m. again for this. I'm gonna do the box writing at 1 to 3 p.m. I'm gonna check in and follow up canvas parking at 3 p.m. Okay. So does it make sense? Okay, so meaning beginning of the week, ito yung mga major tasks or projects na we want to accomplish. So normally maganda yan, yun nga, like I said, early morning, in the Monday morning, na plan mo siya or by end of the week, like every Friday afternoon, or minsan me, I do it on a Sunday night, pinaplano ko na yung task ko for the week. Diba? Now, how do you handle naman your day-to-day? Kasi nalatag mo na yung for the week, diba? So, let's imagine, ako gagawa lahat nito. Alright? So, alam ko na this one I'm gonna do on, sabi natin kanina, Tuesday. This one I'm gonna do Monday morning. This one I'm gonna do, nakalimutan ko na, pero say Thursday. Tapos this one is Thursday PM. Ganyan. So alam ko na for today, Monday, this is what I'm gonna do. Coaching content. So I'm gonna block my, so I'm checking the Monday, no? I'm gonna block my 8 to 12 PM. PM. Lunch. To do the coaching content.
8 PM.
Yung tawag natin dyan is time blocking. So put it like in this case, no? 8 to 12 PM. So ang tawag natin dyan is coaching content. Pero alam natin kasi na we also have messages to attend to. Okay? Meron tayong mga notifications sa chat, meron tayong notifications sa messenger. Ang ginagawa ko personally, I turn it off. But every, on the 25th hour, say 8:25, 8:55, 9:25, 9:55 until 12, I check the messages. While I'm doing the coaching content. Okay, how do you call it asynchronous task management and asynchronous communication? Diba? Okay. So, like for example, sinabi ko dito na I'm gonna do a check-in at 9 a.m. May sisingit ko pa yung 9 a.m. dito. Kung 15 minutes lang kasi yan, that's a quick check-in of the SSS field help. Okay, so another approach is every 1 p.m. to 2 p.m., I'm gonna do my email. Okay? May mga cases lang kasi, like for example, the reason why we're doing this, because, halimbawa, yung sa enrollee, na dapat we respond at least every hour. Actually, this is just a sample, ano? But you can do every hour. Bawa, every 9:05, 10:05, 11:05, yun yung cadence mo of answering messages, di ba? Okay, pero at the end of the day, you know na begin ano pa lang for Monday, this is your highlight of the day. You're doing these things, mga minor things, mga messages, etc. Pero by the end of the day, you will be fulfilled because natapos mo yung main or major project mo, which is the coaching content. Tapos yun nga, kung may mga meetings ka, 2 to 4 p.m. Well, itong coaching webpage, you don't have to do it at 8, ano? Kasi kung commitment mo naman is for the entire week, you can split this in 2 days, di ba? Instead of just Tuesday, kayo mong Wednesday and Thursday. Pero, yung ginawa natin kanina, the matrix of Monday to Friday, ideally, you plot na yung mga stuff there. So that clear in your mind if those things assigned to you are doable or not. So kung hindi, then you have to discuss it with the team. I don't think that's doable because if I plot it here, I don't have time. Unless you put here like every 2 to 5 p.m. you do socials, social media, di ba? So hindi mo talaga matatapos yun. Because yun ang priority.